The next behavior I'd like to discuss is the scroll to behavior. In the last video, on the bound to layout behavior, we talked about how the layout size can be larger than the window size, and we looked at an example where the player left the screen. The player was bound to the layout, so he was contained within the layout, but he left the screen, exploring the hidden area outside of the window. With scroll to, the view will follow the player or any other object you specify by staying centered on it when possible. So you won't be able to travel off the screen like last time. Let's take a look. I have a larger layout here, much larger than any of our previous examples. The window size is 800 by 600, but the layout size is 2732 by 1536. I've got a player object here, a rocket ship, that I've already added the 8 direction and bound to layout behaviors to. Just like before, we can fly off the right side of the screen and the view doesn't follow. Let's fix that by adding the scroll to behavior to the player object. Click on Behaviors, Add New, and select Scroll To under the General tab. Scroll To has a single property, Initial State. Initial State determines whether or not the behavior is enabled at the start of the layout. The default is enabled, or you can set it to disabled and enable it later during gameplay through the event system. If I preview the layout, you can see that the view follows the player, staying centered on him as he explores the layout. Earlier I said that scroll to keeps the view centered on the object it's applied to when possible. What I mean by when possible is when the object is near an edge of a layout, it can't center the object without moving the entire window. The edge of the layout is bound to the edge of the window. There's a way to keep the object centered while using scroll to. Under layout properties, change unbounded scrolling to yes. Now, when I preview the layout, the player object is always centered, but we have all this blank area where there's no background. I'm not going to fix the whole layout, but you can just drag the BG sprite onto the layout and place it outside of the layout. Now, when I preview the game, space continues on to the left side of the screen, but we're stopped at the edge of the layout. There can be multiple objects with a scroll to behavior applied as well. In that case, the view will be centered right in between the objects that have the scroll to behavior. So, if I add another ship to the layout, when I preview it, the view will be centered right in between these two ships. If I add a third ship, you can see how the view is centered relative to all of the objects with the scroll to behavior applied. There's one last thing you can do with the scroll to behavior, which is add a bit of shake or wobble to the screen. But we need to use the event sheet to do it. I already have an event added that's triggered when the player is moving. I'll click on Add Action and select the player object, and under scroll to, select shake. I'll turn the magnitude down to 10 and preview the layout. Now, whenever the player is moving, the screen will shake. If we added some sound, this would make a pretty nice rocket effect. So, I hope you guys are starting to see how we can combine these behaviors so that they work together to provide the functionality we're looking for. Make sure you master each of these so that you'll have a wider palette to draw from when creating your own games. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Comment, like, and share this video, and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.